Oikawa has dedicated his entire life to the sport of volleyball, spending countless hours trying to perfect his craft and be the best setter he can possibly be. The setter is the control tower of the team, similar to the quarterback of a football team and point guard of a basketball team. Every potential spike, every potential offensive point lying at the hands of the perfect set. However, no matter how hard Oikawa works, no matter how much natural talent Oikawa possesses, he always falls short. No matter how good he plays or how well he sets up his teammates, he has fallen at the feet of the genius, Uchijima. Oikawa is the first antagonist of Haikyuu, and is important for the development of our two main characters, Hinata and Kageyama. So since Haikyuu Season 4 is about to continue airing, and we will continue to see the national tournament in its full, I want to take a look at Oikawa's role as the antagonist of Haikyuu Season 1 and 2, and how he paved the way for Haikyuu to continue to evolve in its later seasons. Before we start this video, make sure to check out my Patreon to support me. You will get access to behind-the-scenes videos, my Patreon-only forum, and your name at the end of every single video. Oikawa is first introduced in the story about 5 episodes in. So far, we have been getting some rule introductions and a feel for who our main characters are. At this point, Asahi and Nishinoya haven't even been introduced yet. And then we get the first match between Karasuno and Alba Josai. Except this match is just practice, with Karasuno missing 2 of its best players, and Alba Josai also missing Oikawa for the majority of the match. When Oikawa is first introduced, we get a few things of importance right away. He is injured from overpractice, popular, and has swagger. These 3 traits are vital to his individual development and the development of Karasuno when they face him. Then we see him play at the end of the practice match. His skill in volleyball far outmatching that of Karasuno's best players at the time. This moment in the story is important for a few reasons. I know since it is a sports anime, power scaling isn't really a thing, but this sets the bar for Karasuno, how good they will have to become, and how hard they will have to work. If Hinata, Kageyama, and the rest of Karasuno want to make it to Nationals, then they will at least have to match the skill of Oikawa and pass it if they want to compete at a high level. But Oikawa isn't just a bump in the plot for Karasuno to overcome, but a brilliant character in his own right, with his own pushes and pulls that make him go from despicable to where you almost root for him to win. I have talked about Oikawa in a video once already, about the heartbreak of his character and how he is one of my 3 favorites in the series so far. Oikawa puts in the work to be the best setter in the world, and he has the drive and the smarts to be able to play with the best people out there. But he also has an immense amount of pride, that pride at times shadowing for what might be his best decision, to go play for Shiratorizawa. With a spiker that could fully match his talents in Uchijima, Oikawa would have the chance to play on the biggest stage, and have a player who would push him to greater heights. But if Oikawa was to do that, he would be leaving his best friend behind and joining the person he wanted to beat most. Oikawa wanted to make it to National on his own terms, with his team, not joining someone else's. One of the biggest reasons for Karasuno's success is the relationship between Hinata and Kageyama, them both finding the right person who can push them to newer heights. And that is the first lesson that needs to be learned in Haikyuu for Karasuno to have a chance to make it to Nationals. They need to fuel each other to get better. If not, they have no chance. That lesson first being learned through Oikawa. For Karasuno to be able to overcome Alba Josai, then Hinata and Kageyama must push each other to be the best possible versions of themselves, something they will have to continue to do during nationals. Oikawa fits in the story perfectly because of how he opposes who Kageyama is as a person, but he also has his own internal pushes that make him a well-thought-out character. The best villains in a series are equally believable and compelling as a character, as they are a device for our main characters to grow. Oikawa's influence on Kageyama cannot be understated for its importance for both them and the narrative at large. When Kageyama was in middle school, he looked up to Oikawa for help, and saw how amazing of a player he was. He viewed Oikawa as a mentor until high school hit. Kageyama then starts to view Oikawa as a rival, a person that he must beat if he wants to be the best. Kageyama envies Oikawa's ability to match any spiker, and how he has full command of his team, but Oikawa laments Kageyama for his insane talent level, thinking that if he had that raw natural talent, he would be unstoppable. So at a glance, we have the classic talent versus hard work argument, but of course, Haikyuu adds so much more nuance to it than that. Oikawa is supremely talented. On almost every court he has stepped on in his life, he has been the most talented player. But in sports, or any field for that matter, when you aim to be the best, you can't do it for 95% of the places you play. It has to be every single game. And that is the issue Oikawa runs into. And Kageyama is no doubt a truly talented person, one of the most talented in the series. But to say that he doesn't work hard would be missing the point of his character. Kageyama has talent, but he also has the work ethic to put everything together. His weakness comes in how he treats his teammates, the biggest strength of Oikawa. Kageyama and Oikawa both holding the title King of the Court, mirroring each other in many ways, but the small differences are what push both of them to be better and evolve in the narrative. Kageyama learned to trust his teammate, Hinata specifically, and give his talent to the spikers on the team. Oikawa sees again the value of having teammates that can bring the best out of you. Oikawa has spent much of his time bringing out 100% of the potential of the players on his team, but his teammates haven't been able to do the same with him. Now where we are at in the story, Oikawa's development in this regard still has a ways to go, and I know that the manga readers know exactly what development he gets, so I might have to revisit Oikawa in the future, but for now I am an anime only. Oikawa and Kageyama's relationship is the core of the Alba Josai matches at the end of the first two seasons, but these matches are also important for the entire team. Not in the grand scale way of the finals match against Shiratori Zawa, but in a deeply personal point for the team to truly feel like they have made it. Oikawa in a way symbolizes what everyone on Kurasuno wants to be. While Kurasuno is called the Wingless Crows, Oikawa is viewed as a poster child for good volleyball. Tanaka and Nishinoya want any girls to notice them, but they are all too busy looking at Oikawa. In the first high school tournament for Hinata, Kurasuno seemed like they had a real chance to make it to nationals. That Kurasuno could beat Alba Josai and then take down Ushijima and Shiratori Zawa. Until Oikawa reads Kageyama perfectly and wins the game. The ending of Season 1 is where the series took on a different form for me. I thought the first 20 episodes were pretty good. I was enjoying the series and having fun, but it wasn't anything special. Until the first match with Alba Josai. This match just had a different tone to it than the rest of the matches up to this point, and a big part of that was Oikawa's presence. He was the first character, the first antagonist, that was there for more than just a few episodes and then gone. Yes, we have the setup between Kurasuno and Nekama, which hits at some long-term storytelling for later in the series, but they are not a true antagonist. Up to this point in the series, when Kurasuno goes up against another team, the antagonist that is focused on is only because of their physical abilities, which is the main obstacle of the match. And yes, Oikawa is a talented player, probably the second best they have faced up in the tournament so far in the anime, but his role is so much more than that. Being what everyone on Kurasuno wants to be, being the foil to Kageyama, the engine of their roster, and lastly, Oikawa having his own deeply rooted struggle with falling short of Ushijima for his entire career. No matter how hard Oikawa tries, no matter how many hours of training, how much film he watches, he will always come up short to the raw talent and strength of Ushijima. Oikawa can put together the perfect roster, have the perfect set, and yet he falls short to the overwhelming talent of others. Oikawa is that person you know who is better than most people at a specific thing, but somehow falls short to the very best. Oikawa left in a weird limbo of likely being one of the best setters in the entire country, but never getting to show off his skill. If Oikawa were to make it to nationals, then he would get the recognition that he deserves. He would be seen as the unbelievably talented player that he is. I am convinced that if Oikawa was given the chance to play on the national team that Kageyama and Ushijima have been invited to, that Oikawa would improve exponentially because of it. Would he make the team in the end? I'm not sure, but the talented spikers there would force Oikawa to improve and show just how talented of a player he is. Oikawa just needs to be given the chance to play with the talent to take him to the next level, but his pride would not allow for it. And I don't think that is a bad thing, but an admirable one. Oikawa's pride makes him go from this unlikable snob to a deeply empathetic antagonist, who the main characters need to overcome, but never truly leave behind. Since we are at Nationals now, and Oikawa has been left out of the story for most of Season 3 and Season 4 so far, I think it is important to look back at how brilliant of a character he is. Oikawa paved the way for future antagonists to rise up in Ushijima and now the Mia Twins, with I'm sure more to come in the future. But I don't think we can forget the amazing accomplishments of Oikawa as a character, and why he is so important to the narrative of Haikyuu. Without him, Kurasuno likely never takes the step to beat Ushijima and make it to Nationals. Without Oikawa's role as the first antagonist, the story of Haikyuu might never have gained the immense popularity that it has received. Oikawa is one of my favorite characters in the series, being a great example of the nuance that is given to these great characters. With the anime starting back up, I can't wait to see what role he plays next, even if it is a small one. I think the last match we see Oikawa play in captures his character perfectly, specifically his last moments on the court, when Hinata hits the final blow to give the win to Kurasuno. Oikawa seeing exactly what is happening, asking for Hinata and Kageyama to give them their best move, and then positioning himself in the perfect place. Oikawa is ready to receive Hinata's spike and give Aoba Josai a great chance to win. Even though he is in the perfect position, Oikawa isn't able to make the play because the ball slightly hits off of one of the blockers, leaving Oikawa and Aoba Josai tragically on the losing side. This moment captured Oikawa's pride in decision-making in one hype and sad moment. There will always be a winner and a loser, but I think Oikawa shows that you gain nothing if you don't put everything on the court. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I am so excited for Haikyuu to return. I have been holding off on not reading the manga because I knew that the second half of season 4 was right around the corner. So let me know what you guys are thinking going into the second half of Haikyuu season 4. I'm sure after the season, I probably will just have to read all of the manga. If you want to talk to me, hear my kind of weekly thoughts on the episodes, follow me on Twitter at AnnieEssays, and if you want to support me, join my patrons at Patreon, the link is down below. There's definitely going to be more Haikyuu videos coming up in the next few months while the season is airing, so I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I hope to see you in the next one.